Hello and welcome to the next episode of my channel, where I'll be taking up the lesson Discovering Tut. Now Tut over here is Tutankhamun, who was the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. Now there are a lot of mysteries regarding his death, because one such reason is that he died at a very young age. Second thing is, with his death came the end of a very, very powerful family, a very, very powerful dynasty. So in order to find out the reason of his death, a CT scan was conducted on his body to find out new clues about his life and death. So this chapter basically talks about the forensic reconstruction of this boyish pharaoh. Pharaoh means Egyptian king. Now, King Tut was just a teenager when he died. He was the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was buried and forgotten over the years. Okay, so this CT scan was going to reveal the cause of his death. Possibly was going to reveal the cause of his death. So at 6 p.m. on January 5th, 2005, the world's most famous mummy was taken out from its burial tomb. As the mummy of King Tut was being put into a scanner for performing a CT scan, at that moment, angry winds stirred and dark clouds covered the stars. The weather had been overcast all day and dark clouds covered the stars. The night sky was hidden by the clouds. The CT scan was being done to obviously reveal the medical mysteries regarding the untimely death of him. Now, King Tut's tomb lies 26 feet underground in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valley of Kings. Now, one amazing fact was that even though his body was in the Valley of Kings, his body was kept quite separate from the other pharaohs. Tourists from around the world came to visit the tomb to pay their respects. They gazed at the murals on the walls. Murals are the paintings on the walls of the burial chamber, and looked at King Tut's gilded face. Gilded means decorated face with gems and all, on the lid of his outer coffin. Now the people standing there had either of the two thoughts. First thought, they were scared that, you know, some kind of curse would befall them because they were disturbing a mummy. And the second thought was that they were curious and thoughtful. They were hopeful that new revelations would be found out after the CT scan. Now, Howard Carter was a British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered, he was the one to discover. Now, this CT scan is being taken place in 2005, but the tomb was discovered in 1922 by Howard Carter. Its content remains the richest royal collection ever found. There were dazzling works of art in gold, and that is why many people were attracted towards the tomb. King Tut was also buried with everyday things. Now, as we know that the Egyptians believed in life after death, so there were many items inside his tomb, like board games, a bronze razor, cases of food, clothes, wines, etc., that he would need in life after death. Now, Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, explained that the mummy was in a very bad condition and it was all because of what Howard Carter did. Okay, Howard Carter found King Tut's body in three nested coffins. Three nested coffins means one after the other. There were three coffins and the body was in the lowest coffin. In the first coffin, he found a shroud decorated with garlands of willow and olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and cornflowers, which indicated, because these leaves and all grow in the month of March or April, this indicates that the burial took place in March or April. Now, when Howard Carter was finally able to reach the innermost coffin, as I told you, the body was in three coffins as in consecutive, okay? And the body was in the innermost coffin, and when he finally reached the mummy, he ran into trouble. The body had stuck to the coffin because of the resin, okay? And what did Howard Carter do? He did a very, very ruthless thing. He tried to loosen the resin by putting the mummy outside in the sun that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit. For several hours, the mummy was set outside in blazing sunshine, but nothing happened. And then what he did? He reported that the tough material had to be cut from the limbs, from under the limbs and trunk to free the king's remains. So he cut the body in order to separate it from the coffin. The royals in King Tut's time believed that they could take their fortune with them after death. Hence, King Tut was buried with all his expensive belongings. To separate King Tut from his ornaments, Howard Carter's men removed the mummy's head and cut off nearly every major joint. Then they reassembled the remains of the body on a layer of sand in a wooden box with padding. So this is why the mummy was badly injured. It had been chopped. It had been cut to take it out from the coffin in order to take the gold and all, to study the ornaments and all. And Howard Carter, in his escape, he says that if he would have not done it, definitely a thief or somebody would have plundered the coffin. Anyways, in 2005, the body was in a very, very bad condition. Archaeology has changed since then. Since 1922, archaeology has changed a lot. Earlier, the archaeologists focused on treasure and less on the fascinating details of life. But now, the things are opposite. Now, archaeologists are more focused on the life than the treasure. So in 1968, more than 40 years after Howard Carter's discovery, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed an astonishing fact that beneath the resin that caked King Tut's chest, his breastbone and front ribs were missing. King Tut's demise was a big event. Okay, why? Because he was the last ruler. So what one astonishing fact that came out after the x-ray in 1968 was that the rib cage, one of the bones of the breastbone, one of the bones in the rib cage was missing. Again, a very startling thing. How it happened? What happened to him? Nobody knows. Now, a little bit of history about Tutankhamun and his ancestors. King Tut's father or grandfather, Amenhotep III, was a powerful king who ruled for almost four decades. His son, Amenhotep IV, succeeded him. But he was a very strange king. He promoted the worship of Aten, the sun disk, and changed his name to Akhenaten. He moved the religious capital from Thebes to Akhenaten, now known as Amarnath. He shocked the country by attacking a major god, Amun, by breaking his images and closing down his temple. So, in other words, we can say that he tried to reverse all the religious beliefs of the people. He said it must have been a terrible time of the people. Okay, so Ray Johnson, a professor in Chicago, says that it must have been a very, very terrible time for the family at that point of time. After Akhenaten's death, Smenkhare, a mysterious ruler, ruled for a brief period, but he didn't leave hardly any sign or anything. And that is when Tutankhamun took over the throne, and he soon changed his name to Tutankhamun, known as King Tut today. And he oversaw the revival of the old ways. And that is why Tutankhamun is famous. King Tut is one among many mummies in Egypt. The Egyptian Mummy Project has recorded almost 600 and is still counting. King Tut's mummy was the first mummy to be CT scanned to ascertain the secret of his death by a portable scanner donated by National Geographic Society and Simons. King Tut's entire body was scanned during this process. And on the night of the scan, workmen carried him from the tomb and rose it on a hydraulic lift into a trailer that held the scanner. However, initially, the costly scanner could not function properly because of sand in the cooler fan. But soon after the scan was successfully performed. So people again say that because the fan stopped working, maybe it was the curse of the pharaoh. So after the CT scan was done, the king was returned to his coffin to rest in peace. The CT scan showed an astonishing image of King Tut and his entire body very clearly. It showed a grey head, neck, vertebrae, a hand, several images of his rib cage and a section of the skull. Zahi Hawass was relieved that nothing had seriously gone wrong because they had taken out a relic out of the ground. As the technicians left the trailer, they saw the star constellation, which the ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of the Osiris, the god of the afterlife. They felt as if the god was watching over the boy king. So I hope you have understood the lesson. Do like the video.